Hi and welcome to This Is Your Life. Well, as you can see, the studio is set and we're all ready to honour a performer who has literally been idolised around the nation. Plenty of well-known faces are rolling up to celebrate the life of a country kid who has defied his critics and battled the odds to become the most successful chart topper in Australian music history. Welcome to the show as we celebrate the talent and accomplishments of Shannon Noll.
Shannon Noll. All the world believes that you
will. Ladies and gentlemen, Shannon Noll. Take a seat, mate.
Oh, wow. Thanks for that.
You don't really mean that, do you? It wasn't until you took your sunglasses off that I realised that you were seriously worried.
Well, you know, a lot of times there's probably something to worry about.
I mean, seeing that footage of Shannon's very first audition there when he came in and sang Hold Me In Your Arms and then went on to sing songs like Better Man and so on, the beautiful, quiet ballads, and then there was a point at the series where he became really confident in his own skin and decided to really dig deep and make his own decisions. To see the development through the show was fantastic.
OK. That first Idol contest back in 2003 is both close and full of controversy, particularly when fellow finalist Cosima De Vito unexpectedly drops out of the competition.
Unfortunately, I have a temporary condition that's affecting my voice. It's forced me to make the decision to leave the competition.
Now, Shannon, Cosima's departure clears the way for you to make the grand final and go up against Guy. There's no way that Cosima was going to miss tonight's show. So, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Cosima De Vito. Now, you must look at these two guys, Guy and Shannon, and think what might have been had you not had to drop out.
Look, you know what? I'm happy it was them two. You know what? Regardless of what would have happened, he deserved to be in the top two, and his success is a testament to that.
Thanks, Dan.
You know what I mean? Like,
did you?
That's it. And I was a big fan from the beginning, right from the beginning. Like that big, powerful, passionate voice. It was just, yeah, he had me from the beginning.
Okay. All right, well, thanks, Cosima. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
With Cosima no longer in the competition, it's down to the wire between you two as over 3 million Australian viewers tune in to see whether Guy Sebastian or Shannon Noll will become the first ever Idol winner.
The winner of Australian Idol 2003 is... Guy Sebastian.
Guy, that is a life-changing moment, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. You know, our lives have totally been changed from that. It's been a real big trip, and I'm so proud of Shannon and so proud of what he's done, not only musically, but also the person he's been.
Yeah, but of course it's your ability to reach and relate the average Australian that has maintained your success since Idol. And not everyone, I have to say, has been happy to see you make it.
Here we go.
He calls himself an Australian Idol. Pig's ass!
Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome Reg Reagan.
Hey, mate. Hey, mate. you.
They're right, Reg. What is your problem, mate? What is your problem?
You look great, mate. How are you? You're doing really well. Still doing the yoga?
Still doing the yoga. Fantastic. Still keeping trim, taut and terrific?
No, you look great. Hey, Cosima, how are you, darling?
Good. Good, how are you?
Hello, how are you? Oh, thanks very much.
Hey, old son, how are you? Come on, come over here, son. Oh, I tell you what. Mike, I can tell you some stories about this bloke. I've known him since he was a tacker. Back when I was the publican at the condo hotel. I remember this young bloke, only 18 years of age, him and his mates used to come in every Friday night, chasing a bit of skirt.